Hi, Carolyn here, trichologist at Absolute Hair Health Clinic. As promised, we're going to do a series of instruction videos for your home care. So we have our lovely model, Sarah, here today. Thank you. And what we're going to teach you in order is how to prepare your scalp for topical applications at home. So first of all, we're going to use our scalp brush, brush therapy, followed by scalp cleansing. To cleanse the scalp, scalp is skin. You cannot wash your scalp with a hair shampoo. You wouldn't wash your face with a hair shampoo. Tonic is about opening the follicle to then get our topicals down, and we also use our microneedle. So we're going to demonstrate each and every one of these. This procedure is to help treat one, the hair cycle, and two, pattern thinning. So when we're talking pattern thinning, we're talking about female and male pattern thinning. And when we're talking about the hair cycle, we're talking about all the hair follicles on your head are within a cycle. You need to know exactly what you're treating so you know which of these to use and in what order. So please don't attempt to do the home care unless you have had a professional diagnosis of the hair cycle and also the pattern thinning, because they do connect together. Here in the clinic, we tend to find more hair cycle problems than pattern thinning. The hair cycle triggers the pattern thinning to go faster, so you need to understand combination therapy is the best approach. To begin with, we start with scalp brush therapy. The scalp brush therapy is about exfoliating the dead skin cells off the scalp. It's also about, we always just detangle the hair a bit first, which I did, sorry, we pulled it a bit there. We always detangle the hair, and then we're going to exfoliate the dead skin cells off the scalp, because they actually build up on the scalp. The other thing we're doing is we're triggering the little muscle, which is the erector pili muscle. The muscle is attached to the hair follicle and will then go down to the bottom of the follicle where the hair bulb is. At the hair bulb is your blood supply. So we're triggering a lot of energy, and that energy creates heat. So we can feel some heat coming from the scalp. And what it also does is that energy travels back up the follicle and it flushes out this thing here, which is the sebaceous gland. That's responsible for all of your oil. Now, most of the time, we're not cleaning the scalp properly, so therefore it leaves oil on the scalp. So some people say they've got to wash their hair once a day, twice a day. By simply doing scalp brush therapy and cleansing and preparing the scalp properly, you can eliminate the troublesome oil and make sure the scalp is properly prepared for topicals. So we use a nice firm motion, and we work around the head. With longer hair, you have to focus on the scalp. It's not about brushing the hair. Everything is about the scalp, and the scalp is a living organ. The hair is a dead fiber. We're treating the living part, so keeping the brush on the scalp. Now, you want to continue doing this therapy, making sure you're moving over the entire scalp until you feel the heat on the scalp. So I can feel it, and Sarah can feel it. So doing this yourself, you can feel the heat. And what I can also feel is the oil, and I can see the oil coming out as well. So I probably think about 2 minutes is the average time to do brush therapy. You can do it for 20 minutes or 30 minutes, but you need to do it just before you're jumping in the shower. Everything we've now brought to the surface of the scalp is going to irritate the scalp, so it needs to be washed away. So you never do brush therapy if you're not going to go and do scalp cleansing. So if you want someone to do brush therapy because it feels good, make sure you then go and do the scalp cleansing. For yourself, you can tip your head upside down, do whatever it is you need to do, but make sure you're getting that motion nice and firm, nice and even. And the brush that you use should be a nice, strong paddle brush. It should have a cushion, okay, because we don't want to have something hard on the scalp. We're using some nylon anti-static bristles, and the nodules are all connected together, and we like to have a good size paddle brush because it just makes your job easier. So once you've done your brush therapy, you're then going to go through and do your scalp cleansing. So we'll go and move on to that.